everyone. I'm Chrys Peterson, and today on The Balanced Plate, we are talking about a quick and easy breakfast. If you are a busy mom like me, you know that breakfast sometimes is the most hectic time of the day.
That's for sure.
So Kinsy McNamee is here to show us a heart-healthy breakfast that we can make ahead of time, and you can run out the door with it. What are we making today?
We are making whole wheat banana zucchini muffins. The great thing about muffins, it's a great way to add some fruits and veggies, disguise them in a quick and portable breakfast that you can grab and head out the door.
All right, and this is great for all ages too, because sometimes if you have kids of different ages or you can't find something that pleases the kids and the adults, but everybody in the family will love these.
Yeah, who doesn't like muffins?
That's right. Okay, so how do you start?
So we started here just mashing up two bananas. Brown bananas are actually better than your nice and not quite ripe ones because they mush a little bit easier and they add even a little bit more sweetness. So to this, we're going to add one small to medium sized zucchini. You can use a hand grater if you want an arm workout. I use my handy dandy little food processor. So this is about the size of one small or medium sized zucchini. So we're gonna dump that in. And then we're gonna add the rest of our
kids will normally turn their nose up at zucchini, Kinsy. So this is a great way to kind of hide the green vegetable in there, right?
So nobody knows it's there. And if your kids are really picky, like mine can be, you can even put some cream cheese over the top of it so they don't see little green poking through.
Good idea. Okay, we have our zucchini and our bananas, and now what?
We're gonna add the rest of our wet ingredients. For our sweetness, we're adding half a cup of sugar. It's really fine to use any type of sweetener that you would want to. So if you wanted to get fancy and use some agave nectar, you could do that. Honey would be fine, or even pure maple syrup would be okay.
You do sugar substitute for like diabetic purposes?
You could certainly do that. The amount of sugar that's in these muffins is pretty low, though.
Yeah.
Half a cup for the whole serving.
Okay.
So if you were really concerned, though, you could certainly do like a Splenda mix or a different sugar substitute. So besides our sugar, we're going to get some extra sweetness from our applesauce. And we're using an all-natural, no sugar added applesauce. So that's also going to be a half a cup. This also helps keep these nice and moist because we are going to be using a whole wheat flour with these.
Yeah, and even the unsweetened applesauce does also have some sweetness to it, but it's also giving a nice moisture to the muffins, right?
Absolutely.
So half. And by the way, you can use applesauce as a substitute in a lot of recipes, right?
Yeah, it takes the place of some of the oil.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're doing applesauce as a substitute, you would add just like a tablespoon of oil instead of like a quarter or half a cup. And then we're gonna use half a cup of milk.
Just any milk will do?
Any milk is fine. I just used regular skim milk, but you could use soy milk, almond milk. It doesn't really matter. It's just gonna add, again, a little bit of moisture to our recipe. Let me move that.
That looks good.
If that looks good, you'll really like the finished product.
Can you tell I'm hungry? Must be breakfast time.
So to make these heart healthy, in place of butter or your margarine, we're going to be using a quarter cup of olive oil.
Okay, which kind of sounds weird in a desserty sweet item to some people, maybe.
It does. And if you are doing these in like a different baked good, a cookie or something, I wouldn't necessarily recommend it. But the banana flavor is pretty strong, so you're not going to get any of that olive taste with these.
Okay.
And a quarter cup is what we're going to use for our olive oil.
And olive oil, of course, is a much more heart-healthy fat than butter or some of the others, cooking oil, vegetable oil that
this
you could use.
This is high in our poly and monounsaturated fats and much lower in saturated fat than some of those other oils.
Okay.
So then we're just going to mix up all of our wet ingredients, get it all combined here. And then we're gonna start with our dry ingredients.
All right, I'll finish mixing this.
All right.
Give me some work to do here. Now, you talked about the whole wheat flour. Let's talk about that because I think sometimes people think it doesn't taste the same. You know, the food doesn't come out the same, but it's a lot healthier for you.
It is a lot healthier. It is more dense. It's not quite as fluffy as your regular flour. But to keep these as a really heart-healthy choice and as a good breakfast, I would really recommend that you branch out and try it with whole wheat flour, because it's giving you that really good source of fiber. Fiber is especially important if you do have any issues with cholesterol, because that fiber actually binds to the cholesterol in your blood and helps carry it out of your body.
Awesome.
So it's naturally lowering your cholesterol levels. So we are doing 2 cups of our whole wheat flour.
Now for adults, that's important. For the kids, they just know they taste good. So they don't really care about all that cholesterol stuff, but they still taste really good and they're good for them.
So then we are doing 2 tablespoons of baking powder. And really our baking powder and baking soda is the only source of sodium in these. So you're keeping these pretty low sodium as well. And then a tablespoon or teaspoon of baking soda. And then for some extra flavoring, we're doing a teaspoon of cinnamon as well.
Oh, good. Yeah. And don't use the baking soda you've been using in your refrigerator to get all the odors out of the fridge. Just make sure you use the baking soda that's for baking, right?
Those make your muffins taste just a little funky.
We're blaming it on the baking soda.
So then we're gonna mix up our dry ingredients, make sure it's all distributed here. And then all we gotta do is add in our wet stuff.
Pour this in.
Dump it in the middle.
Okay.
Very nice.
I'm pretty sure I could even make these.
As you can see, I mean, we're almost done with our batter here. It's been just a few minutes.
Yeah.
So in this period of time, you can have breakfast really for the whole week for your family. Something that, you know, is going to be good and filling, heart healthy. And like you said, something everyone in the family will love.
Mm-hmm.
Now, obviously, this is going to be lumpy, so really all we're doing in mixing it up is making sure all of the dry ingredients get moistened.
Right. And again, this is something that you could do on a Sunday and then put them in the refrigerator and or in a airtight container, and let the kids just grab one or grab one yourself as you head out the door to work in the morning.
If you want to grab the
really
muffin
good.
Tin for
okay.
me and our spray, we can go ahead and get these in there.
And what kind of spray are we using?
So we are using a canola oil spray. Any canola or olive oil or blend of the two is fine to use.
Okay.
Just lightly grease, just enough so they don't stick. This makes enough for about 12 muffins, and they're decent sized muffins as well.
So you're not putting a little paper cup in there.
No need, they'll come out nice and easy.
Perfect.
And then we're gonna put about 1/4 cup in each tin here, and that's really about 1 heaping spoonful.
Okay. But you can make these even more fun for the kids if you'd like to by kind of improvising and adding some more ingredients, right?
Oh yes, that's right. We'll do maybe 1/2 of these plain, and then we're gonna add some walnuts and some dark chocolate chips to our other 1/2.
Did she say chocolate?
Yes, she did.
Chocolate for breakfast. Like, what could be better, right?
Absolutely. And your dark chocolate is fine, even if you're on a cardiac diet. Basically, anything in moderation is okay. So dark chocolate even does have some heart health benefits. That doesn't mean you eat a whole bag of dark chocolate chips. But a little bit mixed in will give it some extra sweetness, a little bit different flavor.
And listen, all the kids are going to know is there's chocolate in my breakfast, right?
Exactly.
So that's awesome. So you did maybe 1/4 cup in there for
about
1/2 the batter.
And then we're going to add some extra heart-healthy fats and some chopped walnuts.
Okay.
So we'll add, again, about 1/4 cup of those as well.
So you can kind of custom these to the, you know, if you like nuts, you can put nuts in them. If you like chocolate, you can put chocolate. I'll bet even, you know, maybe white chocolate or butterscotch chips would be great.
Or you could even do some dried fruit, some raisins or some craisins in there would be a good addition as well. So I know which ones you're going to go for.
Well, just remember, the more chocolate or whatever the treat is that you put in there, maybe the less heart healthy we're getting.
Well, you're going to have a little bit more calories.
Yeah.
And really, the chocolate chips are just going to add a little bit more sugar, too. But the amount that we've added isn't going to make or break your day. They are still considered healthy. They'll still be a good option for you for the morning.
And of course, for the kids, they don't care. I mean, you're not probably really worried about the kids having a little bit of extra chocolate. And for them, it's just exciting.
Well, and they're getting zucchini. They're getting some applesauce. They're getting bananas. So you're getting in those important fruits and veggies for them as well.
You just tell them you made them chocolate chip muffins. You don't have to tell them about the zucchini.
Exactly. So we have got our oven set for 350. These will take just about 15 minutes. And then we'll have muffins for the week.
And you actually have quite a bit of batter left there.
Yeah.
So this is great for a large family. This would work really well too.
Yeah. Everyone can have one or two a day and you'll last you through the week.
Okay.
Right, we'll go pop these in.
My mouth is watering. These look so good right now. And that didn't take long at all.
Not at all.
And they're really part of your balanced plate.
Absolutely. They're really giving our plate a good source of fiber. We're kind of balancing it out with a good protein. So a couple quick grab-and-go options would be a hard-boiled egg, or even a lighter Greek yogurt's going to give you that extra protein as well. And then to finish it all off, we've got a nice serving of fruit that's also portable. So you can eat this in your car, on your way out the door, kids on the bus, on their way to school.
Right.
And you've got a really nice plate here.
Okay, but I know what you're wondering. How do they taste? So I'm going to let you know. They are so moist. They're so moist. I was a little nervous with that whole wheat flour because I had never done that before, but.
Well, with the applesauce, the zucchini, and then the little bit of olive oil, it does keep it nice and moist even with using that whole wheat flour.
Kinsy, thank you.
You're welcome.
Take my muffin now. You will absolutely love these. Add the chocolate chips if you like, add the walnuts, but they are just delicious and moist and healthy for you.
Great.